Hey everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue our Darkest Dungeon adventure here in week 55? Yeah. Dyrus finally got back from their personal trial of the body. I asked the real Dyrus what that was, and he said he has no idea, so that's good. I did actually ask him, though. So, we did not have an episode yesterday, and I apologize about that. Mainly, that is due to the fact that I have been doing a lot of post-production rendering, and I had to actually re-render the last, Space Food Truck video, and that had to basically go out the same day that TB wanted to release it. It's not like TB gave me a deadline, but I wanted to make sure that my point of view was up, just in case anyone wanted to watch it from my point of view. Same with Ken, same with Cry, etc. So I wanted to make sure that I wasn't the only scrub who didn't have it there on time. So yeah, but that's the reason why I did not have a Darkest Dungeon video today, or not today, but yesterday or the day before. So sorry about that. We've got ourselves a pretty decent spot. I will say that we need to get these lobies leveled up pretty darn harshly and fastly. We could do another long mission here. Do we have a... We do not have a low-level jester who could actually do that. And there's not one available right now. So maybe we won't be able to do that just yet. We could do a short one without a jester, which I mean, I guess is fine. We gotta get some peeps leveled up. So let's go ahead and get... we'll get Simply Jackson. We'll get Boogie. And I think taking Scrub Victa would not be bad, just for the emergency stress healing. And then for the real heals, we've got Dyrone. So Dyrus is back. Let's go ahead and get everyone buffed up. This would be probably a no torch run. I don't see any reason not to. I will go ahead and give that and that to Simply. And Boogie, fresh off of the beautiful like amount of quirks that he has. I mean, he's got Slugger and Deadly. We have to lock that one in too eventually. I'll give him the Wounding Helmet, and we'll also give him another Focus Ring. For Scrub Victa, we will give him... I don't like dropping speed all that much. I think we'll just go with the Dismas' Head, and yeah, we'll go for a Moon Cloak. I can dig it. Of course, last but not least, we've got Dyrus. Dyrus, we've got Junie's Head, and the Surgeon's Trinket. There we go. Let's make sure that we have everything ready to go here as far as the skills are concerned. It's been a couple days since I've actually played. Not that that's any excuse or anything, but, yeah, what do you want to... Go ahead and level that up. But, yeah, the last time I did play, it was actually on stream. It was not, of course, on the YouTube file. And it didn't go so well. I don't know, lately on my... Especially on the Twitch file or the Mosh Pit file... incidentally, is also the one that I use for Patreon. We've been getting some pretty nasty RNG. I mean, and as everyone knows by now, I mean, I am human, despite what some people may think. And I do tend to kind of get upset when it comes to RNG. Like, I don't like losing because of, hey, just got unlucky sort of thing, you know? It's that sort of mentality, so... And that would probably beg the question, well, Invicta, why do you play RNG games when you say that you just absolutely hate losing your RNG? Well, it's because they're pretty fun. The only game that I basically flat out made myself stop playing because it was actually affecting me as far as like bleeding over into other areas of life, like me being so upset that like, you know, like, oh man, I lost, and because it was such BS, blah blah blah, is because of Hearthstone. That's the only game that I've forced myself to say, you know, I have to stop playing the game. It's not fun. Yeah, it's fun when you win, but the highs don't justify the lows. The highs cannot compare to the lows, I guess, is the best way that I can describe that. So, made the grown-up decision, and I know that disappoints some people, and I'm not saying that, like, I'm completely... We should back up here, but such blockages are getting a really early shovel event's pretty nasty. Oh god, I need to make sure that we have the right moves too. I don't think I did Syndicta's moves. But as far as like Hearthstone goes, like I don't want to say that like I'm done forever. Right now, basically, all I've done is I've just removed it from my hard drive, just because I don't want to get the. I also removed it from my phone, incidentally. But I don't want to get like the urge to be like, oh yeah, I'm just gonna play again. And then it's like the whole cycle starts over again. When the con- I mean, I'm probably gonna play Hearthstone whenever the expansion comes out. The Whispers of the Old Gods, and that's gonna be, I'm sure, fun for a while, but I can't- the thing with me and Hearthstone in general is just that I can't take it seriously anymore. And I think that's the best mentality to go into. Not because I think the game's a joke or anything, but it's just because if I take it too seriously, you know, full knowing that, yeah, you're probably gonna lose more than you're gonna win, it's... Another one. You know, it stops becoming fun. I don't make good generalization. Whenever I start taking things like super duper, like try-hardy sort of style, like things become, I don't want to say less fun, but it becomes more serious, and it doesn't create a good environment for entertainment purposes, if that makes sense. Like, I don't want to make something less fun, not only for me, but also for people watching. And that's where Hearthstone really came in. So, and where I'm going with all of this is back to talk to Darkest Dungeon, whereas, like, I took a mini break from Darkest Dungeon. We were getting some pretty nasty RNG, especially in the last dungeon, and I was like, yeah, it's probably good for a day or two break, so. But it was not my intention to take a break from the YouTube series. I just had, I had the Space Food Truck stuff going on, and I wasn't prepared to have to do, like, post-production work on it, because I want it to look nice. I mean, of course, TB did me the honor of not only playing with himself, but also we had Mathis and, of course, Northern Lion. And on top of all that stuff, we also had Sunday's Co-Optional Lounge with Cry and Cinnamon Toast Ken. So, of course, that was amazing. You know, I am truly lucky for to get to work with the people that I do. And I hope to keep on doing it. I mean, that's the ultimate dream, right? Basically, what I'm trying to say is, I hope everyone had a great Easter weekend and had lots of chocolate monies. I'm going to go ahead and delay here one turn just so we can get a little bit of a heal out. Dyrus does need to heal himself here. Six, not exactly the best heal. That's all right. I don't think I can use Inspiring Cry from... Oh, I can use it in position one. I did not know that. I learned something today, although for some odd reason, the Hellion can't move backwards. I also did not know that. It's alright. We'll go ahead and crit heal myself and get rid of all my stress with that crit heal. Very nice. Good job, me. There's a better heal, Dyrus, although he did start bleeding himself, so. Yeah, it's time for leg day. There we go. Disadvantage. Give them no quarter. I'm gonna go ahead and move myself back behind Boogie, just so I have the option to use the Holy Lance in case we do need it. A fortune waiting to be spent. Luckily, we have plenty of food. We did get two food out of the random events that we've gotten so far, random battles. We got four more food. Okay, so we just basically made all the food back that we just ate, which is good. This is an exploration dungeon, meaning that we have to explore 90% of the dungeon, which also means that we can only be allotted to skip, I believe, one room total, which is not a whole lot. 70, 80, 60, 60. You don't have any more bandages, unfortunately. That's okay. We're not here for treasure. Mainly, we're here just for the XP. It's gonna be three wretches. This is a nasty group, especially with all of us being super slow. Hopefully we don't contract any diseases. We'll see. Nice dodge by Jackson. TB, let's go. Not TB, Dyrus. The occultist is always going to perpetually be total biscuit. I mean, I'm going to go ahead and mark the front one. Because we're not going to be able to kill this one. Even if Dyrus critted, he wouldn't have been able to kill that one. Although we can stun it now. I'm surprised that Boogie was actually able to go before the wretch. So we got a little bit fortunate there. Here we should definitely destroy the one. Here we should definitely destroy the one that we're not going to be able to. Well, that figures. All right. Holy Lance should be able to kill one of them. I was thinking about going for the stress heal on Simply Jackson. And there's the crit. 30 stress. And the second one also was able to go before the rest of our team. So yeah, didn't go so well. Could have gotten better, that's for sure. Let's go ahead and get Dyrus healed up. 16, nice heal. For here, yeah, we're gonna delay a turn. And 30, 35. Go ahead and have to keep Simply Jackson up. 7 stress heal, not bad, man. It really is not. And we're not going to delay this turn, obviously, so we definitely want to get this wretch burned down. Between four of us, I think we can do so. Going to throw out another Inspiring Cry on Simply Jackson, and then Boogie should be able to get the smackdown. Got another key. Maybe we'll get lucky and get a secret door. Maybe, maybe not. Don't have any more bandages, so we can't access the blades. We go back to Blackest Pitch before this next fight, which is going to be a big one inside of this room. No wretches, which I'm fine with. The drummers can be a little annoying, but as long as you take down the carrion eaters, you shouldn't really have that much issue. Boogie's going to get smacked down on one. Dyrus throws out a little AoE. I definitely do want to take down the drummer. However, I'm gonna attack the carrion eater that has not attacked yet, because Simply Jackson, she has Iron Swan. So I figure Iron Swan is a very high chance to hit, and also it also hits very, very hard. So there's no reason not to go for the sure thing on the carrion eater that is not attacked yet, in my opinion. I'm gonna go for a stun here. Without a dedicated stress healer, I mean, you want to try to cut corners as often as possible. So this allows me to bring Dyrus' stress down just by a little bit, and then Simply Jackson can kill the carrion eater, and that'd be that.
Seize this momentum. Push on to the task's end.
Actually, that reminds me of tonight, at the time of this recording. Not the time of this recording, just because it's recorded the day before, but tonight, the time of this video going out, we will be doing the next episode of our Dungeons & Dragons group on Domestic Dan's channel. Simply Jackson, she is also part of that group. And it's a lot of fun. D&D every now and then is a right treat. Double Brawler and Drummer. So you can find that, by the way, at twitch.tv/domesticdan. And that'll be happening 6 p.m. Pacific time, which is 8 p.m. my time, and 9 p.m. Eastern. So Dyrus gonna get a huge heal on Boogie. Man, oh man. Throw out the Holy Lance on the Drummer just because. I think going for a stun here would not be that bad of an idea. And Simply Jackson can go for the one that has the stun buff. Unfortunately, she didn't kill him, but that's okay. Nice dodge. Surprising she was able to dodge despite her having a minus 8 from the focus ring. Boogie gets the dunk. 22-23. Let's go ahead and mark you. I don't want to kill him yet, because I'd like to get a stress heal off. This is a little bit greedy. I probably should have stunned. I don't know why I didn't use a Barbaric Yop there, now that I think about it. A little bit of a misplay. Hopefully he didn't come back to punish me. I just wanted to get one stress heal off. Alright. We didn't get punished too bad. So far, no crits. No player crits from our heroes.
Remind yourself that overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer.
Alright, this will be the last hallway we have to go through, and this is one more shovel event, so we are clear of shovel events for the rest of the dungeon. Well, not the rest of the dungeon, but at least up to the point where we can leave without having to worry about taking stress damage or HP damage. Of course, we're going to continue, just because I want to see what's down this last hallway. Got some books. A little annoying, but ancient traps lie in wait. There's no reason not to go check, so. Blood. Unless you absolutely think you're gonna get jumped on by the Shambler or something. Labyrinth may yet prove to be navigable. Yeah, we were able to get through the Warrens pretty darn easily. Didn't get a whole lot of gold, though, but again, we weren't really going for gold. We're more going for Simply and for Boogie. Dyrus also got a level 2, which is nice.
In time, you will know the tragic extent of my failings.
Alright, we did get Jesters, and I'm happy about that. But that means that we're going to have to remove somebody from our roster if we want to keep the Jesters. We've got so many high-level Jesters. Actually, no, I take that back. We only have two Jesters? Really? Did we? Am I forgetting something? How many justices have we actually lost? We've lost two. We lost Huck and we lost In Control. So getting another jester here actually is not that out of the question. The real question is, do we need another antiquarian? Precise Striker's real good. And minus 10 stress damage as well is also real good. I think the answer is no. We don't need a second antiquarian. I think one is good just for one, because honestly, like, am I really going to use the antiquarian like in high level? I think the answer is no. So we'll go ahead and get In Control. Mr. Jeffrey Robertson. Robinson. Not Robertson. I don't know who Jeffrey Robertson is.
At the end.
Let's see here. Yeah, we got, you know what? Let's do one more. Let's just go for it. Let's get one more out there. This entire group except Sinvicta needs a level. So we'll go ahead and toss In Control in there. The mad gamble, I like it. Let me go ahead and I'm going to unequip the trinkets from Sinvicta, because everyone else's trinkets should not have changed. And then for Jeff, we'll go ahead and give him a bright tambourine, and we'll get him a die. Yeah, lucky dice. Sounds good. All right. Like, I like the antiquarian. I definitely can see where a lot of people. I've been seeing a lot of people basically say like they don't really see a need for the antiquarian in the higher level, and I kind of agree with that. I don't really like the notion of writing off a character too quickly, or especially like a new class, especially since you haven't been able to like explore, you know, the benefits of possibly having the class to the fullest. But I will say that the design of the antiquarian, I like it. I do think that the antiquarian has a spot. It's not practical to bring her. Like, I'm not gonna bring an antiquarian to the Darkest Dungeon. I don't see any point of that. Unless that they do something that changes the way that dodge is affecting the higher level stuff, I honestly can say that I don't ever see myself bringing an antiquarian into like an, especially during like a boss battle or something. So really, she's only there to be like a low level padding for your money. We're going to the Wield. Yeah, I think we'll just take standard here. One holy water, just in case we get the troubling effigy. No torches, of course, because we've got Mr. Jeffrey In Control Robinson with us, our newest jester. He's been through three. We've had three different Jeffs, and that's fine.
These paths once. Now they are as twisted as my own ambitions.
So you guys and gals get a 2-for-1 here, because that one was pretty quick. I'm not gonna lie. We'll go ahead and mark one of the ectoplasms. I mean, there's no reason not to, I suppose. Jeff, start taking care of some of that stress immediately. A 40 crit by Boogie. There's our crit. That's the first crit we've had this entire video. We've done an entire dungeon, to my knowledge anyway. I think Dyrus may have gotten a crit like mark or something like that, but I don't. That doesn't matter. That doesn't count for me. Beast carcass right off the bat, which is nice. We get 4 extra food. Since this is another exploration, we have to explore basically everything but one room. So this group right here poses the most danger, especially when the madman dodges 5 damage. Luckily, we do have a jester of force, so we will be able to deal with this. But we're going to have a lot of stress incoming with the Acolyte and with the Madman. So first off, we're going to buff everyone's speed up just in case we need to get an emergency heal out. That goes a little bit faster than our enemies. Nice one shot there. Well, technically, I guess it's a shot and a half. Boogie, Simply Jackson, gets the one shot with the Iron Swan. So now this fight became pretty much infinitely easier. We can take our time. We know that we've got stress heals on the way. We've got good heals from Dyrus. To start cutting everything in half. We also have a great delay game here as well, with Boogie having the not only the flashbang, but also that goes hand in hand with Barbaric Yacht from Jackson. So there we go. I think Dyrus go ahead heal himself. Not the greatest heal, I've got to say. We're absolutely going to stun here. Since we're faster, there's no reason not to. We're going to be faster than them next turn as well. And yeah. Too off lethal and kind of sad face about that. Confidence surges. Go ahead and cut one of them down. In control. Let's go ahead and take care of Dyrus's stress a little bit. And then Dyrus can heal Boogie for 14. Very nice. Nice job, Dyrus. And let's just do it again. Alright. We'll finish off getting rid of all of Dyrus's stress there. Three left. I'll take it. Maybe should have used the smoke bomb there to prevent this damage. It's only 5 damage. He didn't crit, so it's alright. I think there's no reason to not delay one more turn. It's going to be one off lethal with if it bleeds. So go ahead and get one more round of stress healing here, hopefully. There's no reason to stun. We know he's going to die, so. Because Boogie's not going to not kill him. Unless if he misses, then it's possible. There we go. Advantage. Give them no quarter. Alright, got some anti-venom, which is good. Let's go ahead and grab what's inside of the heirloom chest. If only got an abomination locket and some deeds, which is great. Otherworldly corruption. If you are a new subscriber here on YouTube, thank you very much for checking out the channel. I hope you're enjoying everything. I tend to cover not only Darkest Dungeon, but also some Binding of Isaac, as well as, of course, here's the Storm and Overwatch. The second shovel event in the same Farkin hallway, huh, game? Not a fan of this. I mean, if we have to, we can overcome the damage that we're going to be hit with if we have to go through by hand, but I gotta say, having two shovel vents in the same hallway is pretty ridiculous. We're getting a decent amount of loot out of here, though. Evasion incense is actually kind of decent for the occultist, but I feel like there's not really much you can do without using at least the heal for an occultist. And I really think, unless there's one that exists in the game that I don't know about, I would really, really like to see an occultist-only healing trinket. Something that would give him, like, 70%, huh? Something that would give him, like, extra 30% or even 40% extra healing. But it increases, like, the likelihood of you possibly causing the bleed or something. Like, there has to be give and take. You know, I don't expect just a flat 50% on the heal. That would be nonsensical and silly. Yeah, I think Dyrus can go, just weaken him up. Boogie definitely needs to kill the dog. Surprised that we were faster than the dog. Usually the dogs are faster than everybody. Alright. In control, just gonna take care of his own stress. Nice crit by Simply Jackson. Nice, that was a triple stress heal as well. I like that. Beautiful. Alright, Dyrus with a okay heal on Simply. Boogie gets the dunk. 1,000 gold on a fight that respawned after we started backtracking here, so I will definitely take that. By the time you see this video, you would have known if the Hocket patch came out or not for Heroes of the Storm. At the time of this recording, I do not know. So you, congratulations, future people. You get to know something that I don't for once and usually forever. Oh, if I could only get paid for stuff that I didn't know in the world. 6 more food, more citron, which is it's more gold. Pays the bills. Now the only question is, are we going to go up here? And I think we should, unless we see a shovel event. Well, we got scouting, so this is going to tell us. And there is no more shovel event. There is a fight up here, however. I think we should go up now instead of... We're going to have to backtrack once. I mean, I want to go to these curios anyway. So I'm going up here looking for a fight. We don't have to go up here, I should point out. Because we've already explored. If we went down into the right here and went all the way through, this would be 90% of the entire dungeon. But I'm going up here to look for a fight. Back to the pit. So metal. There's another nice heal there on Boogie. And yeah, Jeff, we're just gonna keep on slicing down that stress. Good job. misplay. That was actually a misclick. I meant to click on the one on the rabble that has not attacked yet. So that 5 damage right there is a direct result of that misclick. I mean, I'll own it. I mean, it's my fault, but I didn't mean to not attack the one that hasn't attacked yet. Totally my bad. I think we're good to delay here. No reason not to. It's a rabble. Let's get a heal on Boogie. It's not a great heal. In fact, it dealt more damage it's gonna solve, so I'm not gonna yop just because I don't want to nerf her damage before we go into the big fight. And yeah. There we go. Completely stress-free now on Simply Jackson. That's a better heal there, Dyrus. Fortunately, we don't have any bandages to take care of the bleeding, however. Which is kind of sad face, but that's alright.
As the fiend falls,
Boogie also got rid of all of his stress. Yeah, we could risk it and go for a shallow grave. It was a disease. We don't have any. Oh well, that's alright. We can treat it. Not a big fight, just 3 ectoplasm. I'm not even gonna really worry about. I mean, I'll take care of stress still, but there's no reason to get bent out of shape over this group. Unless they use ectoplasmic transfusion, then of course we have a bigger problem. And yeah, there it is. Ectoplasm perfusion, not transfusion. Excuse me. So now the real fight can begin. Kind of lame, especially since he's sitting at 2 HP, but that's the name of the game. Sometimes you just gotta do it, sometimes you just gotta bear with it. Let's go ahead and drop your damage by a whole lot. Or not, or that 40% debuff. Let's try that again. There we go. A second resist, nice. Well yeah, I guess we might as well just try for the stun then, since nothing else is working. TB, and by TB I mean Dyrus gets the kill there. 11 damage even after using the Yop. In control, we'll go ahead and start killing that Dyrus stress again. Boogie should have a big hit here. 14, non-crit. The old slime smack. Stun Boogie, did not stun Simply Jackson. 14, 13. Yeah, we'll take care of Boogie first. He's stunned right now. 19, huge heal by Dyrus. 2 off lethal, sad face. Double resist, nicely done. And then, just in case, we'll just go ahead and heal for 0 and cause a bleed. Just in case. Just in case something good happened.
Prodigious size alone does not dissuade the sharpened blade.
Alright, I'm not gonna peek into the tent. Usually the tents don't really have really much of anything. So we went looking for a fight, we got a fight. Didn't really pay off for us, but that's okay. If I knew what did and did not pay off for us, I'd probably be a lot richer.
A fortune. Waiting to be spent.
See, 90% disarm. I will continue down this road here just to see exactly what these 2 curios are. I was hoping maybe for a be nice if we got like a troubling effigy or something.
The darkness holds much worse.
There we go, just an empty crate and a torch.
And boogeymen.
Nicely done. All right. Well, that was a lot more gold than we got in the first run. We also got some deeds and some trinkets that we can get rid of, which is going to give us more gold. Final gold treasure for this time around, or the final treasure worth, I should say, is almost 8 Gs. We got 3 in the bank, 4 deeds and 4 crests I'm happy with. Of course, Boogie got the disease, which I'm not too happy with. Guilty conscience is a little bit annoying, but not that big of a deal. I'm going to wrap up there. Thank you all very much. I sincerely appreciate all the support and the love. Not only from the new subscribers, but also the continued support that you all show me here on YouTube. And of course, if you want other ways to support myself, you can go check out my Patreon page, patreon.com/Synvicta. Again, all that stuff is optional, and I make it a point to make sure that all my content is completely free and never hidden behind any paywall. So thank you for watching. Hope you had a fantastic start to your week, everyone. And until next time, and text time, don't forget to text time next time. So long, everybody!